I'm Chris Edwards and welcome to this week's Tennis Warehouse vlog. This week we're going to have a quick look at the new Yonex Percept rackets that are just coming out for pre-sale right now. And be sure we've reviewed all of these, so be sure to check our YouTube channel for our reviews. First up in my hands, I've got the 97. And first things first, digging the cosmetic on these. I really like the green with the little hits of pink and darker green accents on the cosmetic of this one. Really nice playability of these rackets too. Super solid, very forgiving, really easy to use. So if you're looking for something that's getting you into kind of a player spec racket where you've got a lot of control, these are a great way to get into that because they're not hard to use. And a lot of people think about players rackets as being tough to use. These rackets, really forgiving. They come around quickly and offer a really nice solid feel at impact as well. So 97, I was on the playtest for this one, really enjoyed it. I was getting great access to spin, getting just enough power to help me get my first serves away nicely, or big ground strokes, getting them to push through the court. But yet again, I found the racket to come around really quickly so I could inject pace and spin at will, and just a really nice controlled response from these rackets. Felt like a good sense of where the ball was going. So I really enjoyed the 97. I think it's a great racket for the intermediate through advanced level player. If you're a stronger player, you can weight that one up and balance it to your desire because it's plenty of room to do that. And for the intermediate player, I think it's a really easy access to a very controlled offering from Yonex. Next up, we've got the 97D. And this one, you're going to go up a little bit in weight, and you also get a denser string pattern. The D stands for a dense string pattern. So you've got that nice tight string pattern on this one. A little bit more control if you're a flatter hitter. I think this is a great way to go, just because, you know, the more open patterns, you're going to get a bit more flight, a bit more depth and loop out of your shots. This one's going to dial that down a bit. And I like it on approach shots, and especially when I'm closing the net, just because it gives me a more direct response to my target. I get less of a loop and I get more of a straight flight path of the ball. So a big fan of the 97D. These ones do come in a little beefy. We had a couple of these where the swing rate was pretty high and getting into kind of the very similar territory to the 97H, which is the heavy we're going to look at in a moment. Yeah, a little bit more towards the upper intermediate through advanced level for that one right there, I think. Or if you're just an intermediate player and you're really looking for a more direct response and you're a flatter hitter, have a go with the D. Okay, next up is the 97H. This is the most demanding of the rackets we're going to look at today. H is for heavy. This one swings with a lot of mass. It's a big racket. Too big for me, honestly. I really like the D. I love the 97, and I'm real big fans of the hundreds we're going to talk about in a minute. But this one does take some effort to get it moving. It's a big racket. I found if I just was hitting like lined up and going cross court, or I was hitting big line drives with this one, it plowed through really well and offered me a lot of plow through power. But it kind of hindered my ability to flick it around and be creative and create angles just because it was a lot of racket. Wasn't an ideal fit for my swing. Maybe younger me would have liked this one a lot more, I think. But these days, just a bit too much for me. This is a big racket. If you're a big player, love to hit with a lot of pace, you're really swinging big, long swings with a lot of racket speed, this is a great way to go because it offers that super stable response, tons of control. And if you're good enough to use it, I think you'll really, really love that racket right there. Okay, next up, we've got the 100. And this one is super fast and easy to use. Great access to spin. It's the 100 square inches, you know, is kind of that de facto head size these days. And this one, I think, offers a really easy transition into a control-oriented racket. It's fast, it's easy to maneuver. You can really get creative with it, much more so than I can with that 97H. And super easy to roll angles, flick lobs, get creative with a little touch at net. Thought it was a great doubles racket. Nice, easy access to spin, maneuverability, works great on the return as well. So really liked the 100. And then my favorite, I've saved the best for me for last, is the 100D. So this is that 100 head size, but with a denser string pattern. So I get that more direct flight path that I look for because I'm not a huge topspin hitter. I do hit topspin, but I like to hit the ball a little bit flatter. And drive through it a little bit more, and I thought this was a great way to go. I had the maneuverability I wanted to be super creative that I got from both the 97 and the 100, but with that dense string pattern, great fit for me. I loved it in both singles and doubles play, and a really, really nice playing racket. And the more I used it, the more I kind of fell in love with this one. So that's the Percept 100D. That's my personal pick, but I think these are great rackets. Like I said, love the cosmetic, really like the direction Yonex have gone with these. They're super stable, really nice offerings and easy access into something that's a little bit more control oriented, something into that more player spec. I think these are great ways to go across the board. With the exception of that H, you really gotta be on your game or a stronger player, I think, to use that one. Okay, that's all I got for this week. Thank you so much for watching.